Hi everyone, I'm Jeevan, a program manager in the Azure Identity Organization, and today I'm here to explain how developers can diagnose the occurrence of unexpected consent prompts when users sign into an application. There are a few normal situations that will require additional consent prompts even when the user or an administrator has already provided consent. For example, the set of permissions required by the application has changed. The user who originally consented to the application was not an administrator, and now a different non-admin user is using the application for the first time. The user who originally consented to the application was an administrator, but they did not consent on behalf of the entire organization. The application is using incremental and dynamic consent to request additional permissions. Consent was revoked after being granted initially. If you're seeing an unexpected consent prompt, the first step is to check if any of these expected scenarios are occurring. However, there is another situation that we recommend you avoid. The developer has configured the application to require a consent prompt every time it is used. A developer can inadvertently configure the application to require a consent prompt every time it is used by setting the property prompt is equal to consent. This is unnecessary since Azure Active Directory has the capability to intelligently prompt for consent to the users only when it is necessary. Let us have a closer look at this last situation, why it occurs, and how to resolve it. Let's take a look at a demo. Suppose I'm a global administrator in the app registrations page in Azure portal. Let's head over to the API permissions tab. Our application needs a number of permissions, and as the admin, I've already provided admin consent for all the permissions that are needed. You can see that from the green check mark over here. And our users should not be shown any consent prompts because the admin has already provided the necessary consents. Let's now look at the sign-in experience of a user in our application. As you can clearly see here, once the user has entered their credentials, they are being shown an unnecessary consent prompt. Even though the global administrator has already provided all the permissions that the application needs in the Azure portal. We are now back in the homepage of the application. This time, let's try to grab the URL that the application is hitting when the user clicks on sign in, and also have a closer look at the URL via Notepad. We are now looking at the URL that the application was hitting when the user pressed sign in, and we can clearly see a query parameter prompt is equal to consent in the request. This query parameter is actually making the unnecessary consent prompt show up. Let's now look at some code and understand how we can remove this unnecessary configuration. We are looking at the authorization request URL parameters, and we can clearly see that there is a prompt consent configuration over here. Let's now remove this configuration and see if the unnecessary consent prompts are being shown to the user when they sign in. We're back in the homepage of our application, and as you saw earlier, we have removed the unnecessary consent prompt configuration from code, and this time, the user should not be shown any unnecessary consent prompts while signing in. Let's see the sign-in experience now. As you see here, there were no consent prompts shown to the user, and the user is able to successfully sign in. We strongly recommend you not to use prompt is equal to consent and let Azure AD decide when the prompt is needed dynamically and make life much easier for the users. However, the following are a couple of scenarios where we have seen developers deliberately make the prompt show up. The developer wants to inform the user about the permissions. The app developer wishes to ensure the user is informed of which permissions the app will be authorized to exercise, even if administrator has already consented on behalf of the user in question. The developer requires consent from the user themselves, not an admin. The app developer wishes to ensure the end user themselves provides consent independent of what an administrator may have authorized previously. And with that, we come to the end of the segment. We hope you found it useful. See you next time.